Hello friends, today's video is all about calibrating colors. So you might have been facing issues with the colors are coming dark, how to make it light and so on. So today I'm going to be showing you the difference, what exactly happens when you change the color quantity, the color percentage from AcroRib, and what exactly happens. So here you can see, this is our roll-to-roll printer. I am printing a sheet on it. So I have printed one image on this printer with few settings. I'll be showing you what are those settings here. So here you can see, we have made it 80%, white is 100%. And we are getting this print. Till the time this print comes out, I'll be showing you what other things you have to take care of when it comes to color consistency. So the DTF success, I have been telling you guys that DTF is not all about using inks, using modified printers. It's all about how do you cure your sheets. So your curing should be technically good. So we do use, we have these ovens, the curing oven. This is one model, this is another model of the curing oven. This is IR based, this is coil based model. So curing should be technically good. This is a print, we have done it on 80% of color. Now I'll show you the difference, what happens when you do it on 60%, or what exactly happens when you change the colors. If you can see that this image is little dark, you can reduce the amount of color, amount of CMYK. Also check the curing. Most of the people, many of them, like not all, but most of them are using heat guns to cure sheets. No, it's not a good thing actually. You can't expect good quality curing with heat gun, neither on heat press. Heat press is just an alternative to cure your sheets, but using oven, and if you use flash oven, flash curing oven, IR oven, that's always a best option. So in heat press, how do you cure it? You just keep the sheet inside, sheet on it, and you just remove this and maintain a distance and just cure it. So on this oven, you can cure it in 7 seconds. I'll show you how does this flash oven looks like. This is a flash oven. It has got a tray, and above the tray you have curing coil, the IR flashlights. So let us finish with this print. This printer doesn't have a feeding mechanism. You can see that it doesn't have a roller. So sheet feeding, you will never face issue with this printer. And this has a roll module inbuilt. Most of the people now has the same module. So let it print. We use these printers with jig roll. Along with module, you should have a jig roll rolled printing software, because you don't have to, you can actually use it as a roll printer with just modules outside, external modules. You can't actually utilize this printer as a roll to roll printer, but with jig roll software you will be able to use it as roll to roll. Now this print is almost done. I'll also show you the feeding mechanism of this machine. It will never take the paper, like it is direct rod feeding mechanism. You don't have a roller here. You can see in regular printers, you will see there is a roller here. Yeah, this rubber roller. Here in this printer, you don't see this roller. So it's a direct to rod, directly rod feeding mechanism. So let's come back to the point. Printing with 80% and printing with 60%. What is the difference? Exact difference. Same design. Now we will print with the different amount of color. I made it 50% now. Yeah, previously it was 80%. Now I made it 50%. Now I hit on print option. So see, this is how we cure the sheet. And note, slower is the speed of curing, it's always gonna give you good results. Moisture and everything you have to be very careful about. So slow curing is always recommended. In this oven you can cure your sheets in around 7 seconds also, but I prefer to use it at 100 degree Celsius to 170 degree Celsius. Every TPU, every hot melt adhesive has different melting temperature. So it's recommended from wherever you buy hot melt, ask them for melting temperature of that hot melt and do not exceed those melting temperatures while curing or while fusing. The print is ripped now. So you saw that it's fitted directly on the rod, so no noise while taking the sheets inside. It easily took the sheet inside without any issue. You can see here the colors are lighter, but I think I'm gonna get a very good output at 50%. This is our previously cured sheet. Let's see what happens when we have made it 50%. Let it complete. I'll pause the video now. Let it complete and I'll start the video right from the end of the printing. The printer has almost finished printing this job. Let's see what output we are getting with this. So I keep getting calls from people that we are not getting good colors. It's looking darker. It's lighter. So at that point you can just reduce and increase the percentage of color and check whether you're getting perfect output or not. One more thing you can do is the dot size. Try changing this dot size and check what different color output you are getting. Whenever you do photo printing, like a skin tone, if you want to print, here you should make changes to photograph and then print it. I have seen that. This is my opinion. Maybe people are doing something else, but this works fine. I have tried it with my inks, and this is I don't just trade in DTF supplies. I use it. I am myself a printer of DTF sheets and screen. We have DTG. We have everything in house. So we do print and we trade in the same quality material. So we know that what kind of results you'll be getting along with our material, our supplies. And this is not the case only with creatives, inks or whatever we are trading. You can try this with your inks too. See, this is the brightness, tearing strength. I have also made a video on what kind of polyester powder or TPU or PU powder you have to use. Once we finish with this, I'll be telling you, I'll be guiding you how to remove this white outline. So if you don't need this white outline, make sure your design has to be properly cut in PNG. So if you have small pixels, even small pixels here, you will get that white outline. So design has to be a perfectly cut design, and I'll show you on the software what changes you have to make if you want to reduce this white outline. So these are our demo t-shirts. So we have not changed any settings, we have just printed it. You might have seen the same t-shirt in my every exhibition that I do. So it's been 2 years now I've been using this t-shirt for demonstrating. People do stretch it, check it, scratch it. So yes, the print is done. We will cure this print first and then we'll see what different output we have got. So always keep your powder clean. This is mandatory. And add good amount of powder onto it. Once you are done with powdering, remove all the powder. You can see some roll stand there. So here we are in Mumbai and we don't have huge space to demonstrate all these things, but I make it clear every time, this is not for sale, this is not our marketing strategy. No doubt we get inquiries to this, but this is not for marketing, this is for our customers. So let's cure it. One more thing I forgot to tell you, that we have added this cardboard below. So you should never heat your PET film from the side that is from the print side. You should always cure it from the powder side. And to avoid moisture, I cure it slowly, like gradually I cure it. I don't cure it like in 7 seconds or 8 seconds or 10 seconds. If the workload is good, you cure it at slow speed. So this is just to avoid moisture. So see, it's been around a month we have cured this, and no moisture you can see here. This also depends on like your paper quality is what that makes sense. Paper quality has to be very good. The curing is done. No vapors or moistures while curing. So you can now compare output. So you can see this little light and actual colors. And this is thoda sa at dark side. So this is what happens when you change the color percentage. I'll keep it aside like this. And you can, I think you can make out the difference. Here you can make out the difference. This is actual color actually. This is my actual color, but I'm getting this when I have it on 80%, on 60%, 50%, I'm getting this. So you have to change this according to what your client is asking for or what color output you are getting with your rings. So that's it. Subscribe if you like. Otherwise, don't. Thank you. Thank you once again. Prabodh here from Creative Digilabs Private Limited. A brand, a name you can trust. Thank you.